Why a bidet is necessary. Guys, bidets, okay? You know what a bidet is? It's a little tool. Well, if you got a fancy toilet, your bidet is attached to your toilet. And that's really cool. And then you can just spray your buttocks after you shit. And it cleans it, right? That's what a bidet is, right? They also have hand ones, which I don't know about that. You got to get the whole toilet thing. You can't just have a bottle with a spout at the end that sprays out water to spray your butt. That's not sanitary. But listen, if you got poop on any other part of your body, would you wipe it off with a napkin or toilet paper or a paper towel? No. You'd clean that shit. So, can you imagine what your butt looks like after you're only wiping it with toilet paper? I mean, yeah, I guess that's why you shower every day, but dude, just clean that shit. That's nasty. Anyway, it's funny because I actually don't use a bidet. I do like wet wipes, though. I use those occasionally when they're around. It really is true.
Park or yard?
So they're these people right here, Business Insider, they're explaining what I just talked about, basically. And I heard about that before I saw this video. And then I saw this video, I was like, yeah, that's what I keep trying to tell people. You can't just wipe. You wouldn't wipe
and
poop off anywhere else.
Would you only use a couple of napkins to wipe it off?
Right.
No. You probably wash it off with water.
Right.
And it's for similar reasons that people worldwide use bidets to clean themselves after
using
the bathroom.
That's the point I was trying to make. So bidets, this is like a worldwide thing. This is a common thing worldwide. Like if you go to other countries, you'll see this thing and you wouldn't even know what it was. Like I've learned about this recently. Within the last couple of years, I've learned what a bidet was. And it's a common thing, but not at all in the U.S. I have never been in a bathroom in the United States. And I've been in quite a few bathrooms. At least along the East Coast. No bidets anywhere. But apparently this is a thing.
In Western Europe, South America, the Middle East, and Asia. They're cleaner and more environmentally friendly than just plain old toilet paper. But there's one place where
That's
bidets
true.
Are not so welcome. Which made us wonder, why haven't they caught on in the U.S.?
Yes. Why?
The word bidet actually means pony or small
what?
Horse in French. Since using bidet is similar to straddling a pony.
The first known bidet appeared
in the 1700s. But using water for cleansing had been around long before that. The Middle
East, really?
South Asia, and other regions.
Okay.
You might describe it as a really low sink next to the toilet.
Yeah, dude, if I saw that, I'd be like, I would think that was a sink for a little kid. Swear to God, I'd be like, oh. This is for the short kids. But then how would they use the toilet if they were that small? If it was like a baby. Well, hopefully they wouldn't be in the bathroom themselves, but...
Toilet. Its popularity spread from France to all across Europe and other parts of the world, except for America.
Why?
Part of the reason is that bidets...
Because we're Americans, dude. We're dirty, man. We don't give a fuck. Oh, really?
Americans first saw them in World War II in European brothels.
Oh.
So, many associated them with sex work. By the time Arnold Cohen tried to introduce them to America in the 1960s, it was too late. He couldn't seem to defeat the stigma. And he quickly discovered that no one really wanted to hear about tushy washing 101.
Really?
In the meantime, Japan was taking...
Dude, I'm telling you, Americans don't give a fuck. Don't give a shit. Literally.
...bidets to the next level. Toto, a Japanese company, made some of its bidets electric. So why
See, that's
hasn't
what,
America...
That's what I need. Something to just pop out of your toilet
bidet.
And do it for you.
Well, bathrooms in the U.S. aren't really built for bidets. There's no space or additional plumbing setup for bidet
Because we don't
fixtures.
Care about our bathrooms.
But the biggest reason it hasn't caught on comes down to habit. Most Americans grew up using toilet paper.
Exactly.
And many might not even know there's an alternative way to stay clean.
Yep.
Using a bidet actually makes a huge difference. For one, it's more environmentally friendly. the bidet uses only 1/8 of a gallon of water.
No, it doesn't matter. It's definitely more environmentally friendly than paper.
Of water to make a single roll of toilet paper.
Really?
Americans spend $40 to $70 a year on average for toilet paper and use approximately 34 million rolls of toilet paper a day. Investing in a bidet seat or
shitty people
or a bidet attachment can lower your spending on toilet paper by 75% or more. You'll also be saving some of the 384 trees that are cut down to make a single person's lifetime toilet paper supply.
Whoa.
By now, you might be wondering about wet wipes. Don't they do pretty much the same thing?
No, that's definitely not environmentally friendly.
Constantly wiping can irritate the skin and give you rashes. And it can still leave residue because you're really just smearing with paper. Not only that, but wet wipes are actually harmful to the ocean.
God damn it.
And can cause sewer damage. But
well,
washing
get the
yourself
flushable
with a
ones.
Bidet can help with cleanliness, which may lead to fewer instances of rashes, hemorrhoids, urinary tract infections, and other medical issues. And if you're worried about using toilet water to clean your back end, you shouldn't be. It's tap water, just like the water from your sink.
Yeah,
so
it's not that dirty.
Try. Maybe start.
I mean, it is because it's in the toilet, but as long as it's not in the toilet bowl, then you're good.
Off with a toilet seat attachment, because in the end, it's just washing yourself without hopping into the shower.
See? Can we please install, like, can that just be a thing? Just like they took away vaping, can they just, like, install these toilets everywhere in every household, in every public place in the U.S.? All right, maybe not every household. That's for the house owner to decide. But in every public place, they should definitely install these. Effective immediately. I should be the governor, really.